Here are the parts that we'll need for our film can strummer. First, we'll need some kind of a body. You could use an old wooden box, cigar box, some kind of other tin. But we're gonna use this little film can that I've had around. Along with this, we'll need some wood for a neck. This wood is 3/4 of an inch thick, 1.5 inches wide, and I cut it to be 25.5 inches long. We'll need 10 inches of wood that is 1/4 inch thick, 1.5 inches wide, and I cut it to be 10 inches long. That'll be for the fretboard. We'll need my printable fret guide. We're going to skip the 1st, the 3rd, the 6th, the 8th, and the 13th fret to get the dulcimer scale that we need. Need some fret wire. We'll need 3 tuners. In this case, I'm using classical style, 3 on the side tuners. This is a piece of metal we're going to use for the tailpiece. I'm going to inlay some numbered beads on the side. An assortment of small screws, a little bridge, and 3 small metal guitar strings. I've taped the fret guide to my piece of wood, and now I'll use this fret saw to cut out the slots for the frets. I've made it so that the 0 fret will be about 1/4 of an inch away from the edge of the fretboard. Our fretboard now has slots in it. We can now take our mallet and our fret wire and pound it into the slots. Fretboard is now done. All that's left to do is take a file and round off the edges. I'm now going to cut the side of the tin with a hacksaw to allow room for the neck. And voila, in relatively no time, the neck can be now attached to the body. Before I remove the neck from the tin, I'm gonna mark on the neck close to where it meets the tin, so I'll know where to carve the neck. I have an old tuning plate that I'm gonna use to mark the neck. Now with the holes marked, I can drill holes into the side of the wood, long enough for the tuners, but not long enough to go all the way through the wood. I drilled the holes in the side of the neck, and I also drilled a couple holes along the top. Now that I know where the tuners will be, I marked a line right here, and now I know I need to carve between here and here to make a nice comfortable neck. With the help of my microplane rasp and my random orbital sander, my neck is now nice and carved. I'm now ready to glue the fretboard on. I'm going to glue it so that the 0 fret is 5.5 inches away from the top. I'm also going to cut out a shallow notch here to allow the top of the tin to vibrate. I've now temporarily secured the tin to the neck with a couple screws. I've also added a couple screws back here to attach my tailpiece. By cutting up this tin, it was bent out of shape a little bit, so I also added one little screw back here to keep the back on. Later on, I may apply a little bit of epoxy when I put the screws back in, but even just like this, it's very secure. Once the fretboard has finished drying, I'll inlay my numbered beads into the side of the fretboard. This will be a nice reference for learning dulcimer tabs. Because I'm not using a nut, I put 3 screws in here to guide the strings. This one will go on the left side, and these 2 will both go on the right side. I also installed these numbered beads in the side of the fretboard. Now that we have all the parts, I'm going to disassemble it, sand down the wood a little bit, and then put some finish on the wood. The wood now has finish on it, and it's ready for assembly. And it's done.